It's interesting. Advocacy has always been a component of our history. If you think back to the early days and the Graves family advocating relentlessly on the Hill, and it's through advocacy that we've been able to ensure that this program has continued.
The work we do in public policy is often misunderstood. The policy work that we do really considers what's best for our patients. We're inspired by the things that we hear from our patients and providers. They're the ones who inspire us to do this work and to research and develop policy positions that we can make changes at the state and federal level in order to remove those barriers for patients to be able to get access to the care that they need.
We rely heavily on volunteers to support our work. You know, members of Congress like to hear from their constituents who have been impacted by the program. We can do a lot of advocacy for the program, but the most effective advocacy is when volunteers come forward and talk about how the program's impacted them. Part of advocacy is just making people aware that programs are available out there.
Anybody who goes through a traumatic experience, for the most part, you don't have time to stop and think about how we're gonna do it. You just start doing it. My life got turned upside down, like many people's do, on a dime. Andrew got sick at 11 weeks, went through 3 transplants. Almost his whole life was in the hospital. And Matthew obviously was my firstborn. I didn't know anything about immune deficiency, bone marrow transplant, bethematch, being a donor, nothing. I knew nothing. Ultimately, Matthew and Andrew didn't survive, but I always tell people I am indebted to the National Marrow Donor Program because they gave them an opportunity. Advocacy means speaking up when you have the opportunity about something that you can, right? Like, so I can speak about the importance of getting on the registry, about sharing your story because I've lived it and I'm doing it. Be the Match helped me realize for the longest time I sat like, oh, I'm just this little person and here's these big politics. But then I started to realize, oh, no, like we vote for you. You work for us, essentially. I don't mean that in a snobby way, but like, yeah, like you're right. Like they work for us and I'm a constituent and this is my concern. And I started to realize, yeah, and I do have the power in this situation because I'm going to come talk about something that not only is everybody's worst nightmare, but, you know, I have experience with it and I have knowledge with it and I've worked on getting a pediatric drug through trial and FDA fast track approval. I've done many things in this arena to try to help save lives or improve the outcome of lives. And so I started to realize, no, I have the power in this situation because I'm the expert on it.
I can't think of another program where I've seen so many tears shed in, as part of advocacy, where you've had people come in to meetings, and Kristen Akin being one of them, met with her Senator Blunt from Missouri, and they shed a few tears in that meeting about their life experience and how he appreciated so much her willingness, despite all that she's been through, to continue to be an advocate for this program and talk about the value of this program. This volunteer advocacy that supports our work is one of the reasons that this program has been so successful at not only generating additional funding, but also that the legislation that creates the program is passed every 5 years on a very nonpartisan manner.
In the end, public policy advocacy is all about people. It's people who are telling their stories to our lawmakers to make sure they understand the issue. It's people that are impacted by the policies that we pass and how they're implemented. It's folks that you know, it's your loved ones, it's their caregivers that are ultimately going to be impacted by policy change. And that's really what this is all about, that we can save more lives and get people more time that they need with their loved ones.